Everybody, this thing is Blog, and as you can see, I'm in a new setting. That is because I'm on vacation in North Carolina. So this week I'm going to be telling you about my experiences in the day after it happened, so I can kind of gather my thoughts clearly, and if anything else happens then I'll be good. So I'm going to be talking about yesterday, and ooh doggy, we are in for a ride. Excuse me. So, my mom had to wake me up at 4 a.m., so already we're off to a fantastic start. And it only gets better from there. So, I'm getting dressed, you know, into my outfit. I will be doing a lookbook of the outfits that I wore. And so, later I'm getting ready, and I'm asking my mom why she couldn't have just carried me, because my dad carried me when I went to Florida with him, like, I want to say 2 years ago. And she's like, oh, well, I could have carried you, actually, but I decided because you're older that, you know, you should get to do this with us. I am not amused. So you're telling me that you got me up at 4 a.m. when we had to leave around 5:30, and you're just gonna make me get up? Like, she couldn't even have woken me up later, like me and my brother Michael up later, because the flight was at 9 o'clock and you have to be there, like, it says you have to be there 2 hours early. So we, and it was like an hour away, I want to say, so we could have just left at 6 and we would have been fine, but nope. And then it continued. So I got downstairs waiting, thinking, all right, we're gonna get in the car, okay, let's do this, I'm ready for, you know, an hour of driving, traffic, all that good jazz. But then I hear them saying, oh, by the way, the limo is going to pick us up between 5:30 and 6. And I'm thinking, at first I'm like, yay, a limo, I've never been in one before. But then I'm like, wait, it doesn't take me an hour to have to get ready. So why did you have to give me up at 4 in the morning when I could have just slept? It's not the worst. I've had to get up at 2 a.m. because even though my dad carried me, I was still a little bit awake. So, yeah. And then, I'm like, all right. And then I am 4. So where my grandma and grandpa live, there are two. The street that they live on, the exact house that they live on, there's another place, like one town over, with the same address. So the limousine goes there and like, why aren't you here? Why aren't you out? And they're like, wait, it's not you're not here. Did you put in Danbury? And they're like, oh, shoot. And they're like, dang. It's just like, and then it's just a mess. They're like, oh, and then, I don't know if you know this about me, but I have anxiety issues, and that wasn't help when my grandma said, oh, we're probably gonna miss the plane, but it'll be okay, and I'm just like, A, drama queen, and B, that's not what you should be saying right in front of us, okay? And so, luckily, the limousine got there, like, a bit later, maybe around, like, 6, like, right at the end, they were able to get there, like, and I'm stumbling because it's all on the spot. So, you know, we're driving, So there's a person driving the limousine, and so when they called my grandparents' house, the person, didn't speak very well English, so I don't blame that on that, okay? I'm just saying. So my mom couldn't really understand what they were saying, and she repeated herself a few times, saying, you know, where to go, so that way they know, hey, go here, not here. And so, anyway, the driver was there driving us, and so I wanted to sit next to my mom and my grandma, and my brother and my grandpa were right behind us, and I think, like, diagonally this way, it's probably going to be reversed because of the images, and it was because I'm just going to, because there are two directions, so I'm just going to say this way, which is going to be left for you guys, was mint. I don't like mint, but to the right of me, this is hopefully going to point to your right. I'm not sure how this reversing thing works, really. There was, like, some kind of candy, so I'm not sure. And then, like, right next to my grandpa, there was, like, a cooler with soda. And my brother's like, cool, I want some soda. And I'm like, it is 6 in the morning. How the heck do you want soda? And, like, my brother's changed a lot for the years. Getting increasingly less childish. And so, yeah, that happened. And so we were driving, and what happened, and then we get there, and Grandma's like, oh, we're so late, and my mom comes over here like, we are over 2 hours early, we are fine. And, here comes the juicy part. Okay, so the limousine drives away. I brought 2 backpacks and a suitcase, or so I thought. I had packed it in, you know, put it in the limousine. It was in the back trunk. But here's where it gets juicy. The limousine drives away, and we all look around and are like, wait, where's Sophia's suitcase? The limousine had taken my suitcase. And my grandma made a joke, like, saying, oh, well, guess we'll have to buy you new clothes. Luckily, my iPad and stuff was in here, so I was able to film it. Anyways, but then, like, we're like, oh, wait, they just drove away, so maybe they can come back. So we call, and like, oh, you have our suitcase. So they came around, brought it back, you know, all that stuff. But here's the thing. How do you forget a piece of luggage? Like, I wasn't getting it out because I just was barely awake. So I had my stuff with me. And it was dark purple, but it's still pretty bright. And it's not that small either. And I'm just going to give you a quick backstory on my suitcase because that's a whole nother video. So basically what happened is, on my birthday, which was June 7th, if you saw the video that I made about that, and so I saw that, because I'm going to Frozen on Broadway, which is a musical, and I'm so happy to see it, I wasn't getting too many presents this year, but, what happened was there was a big old, present. It was like wrapped in glitter paper, and I was like, oh, maybe I'll get a cool toy. I unwrap it, and there is legitimately a suitcase, and it's from my grandma, and to this day I have not forgiven her for her for it. She's gonna live with that for the rest of her life. I literally had to go excuse me, and I had to run to my room to cry for like half an hour. And it was horrible. And I remember I just wouldn't talk to my grandma for the rest of the day. I'm still mad at her for it. Because I told her, you don't wrap something in glitter that's just going to be a toy. It's just not going to be a toy. Like, you know, I wouldn't be as mad if it was clothes or something. Or, like, something else. Or, even if, then I wouldn't be mad. But she wrapped it. If she had gotten it for me, even just a day after my birthday, and said, oh, well, there's a suitcase, and it happens to align with your birthday, so, but, you know, I'm getting it anyways. And I was mad at her. I went back to school the next day furious. Like, it was Friday, so luckily, so I didn't have to deal with people going, oh, why do you look like that? But I told one of my best friends, Dottie the Wolf, she's been on this channel before, like, oh my goodness, like, I have something important to tell you, like, and I said this to all my friends, like, how, about the suitcase incident, and they were shook. And Dottie's like, she legitimately just did that. She was speechless. And so, back to now. So I get it. My mom has this thing, did this thing where it's TSA pre-check, so that way we don't have to go through all the stuff. We'd have to walk through the metal detector that you have to go through and put our bags through that stuff. I walked through it and I'm fine. But here's the kicker. So, I don't know if you know this, but my grandpa is deaf. So what they did was they put cochlear implants in his brain and hearing aids. And he also had knee surgery, so he's got metal knees. So he went bang. So I was like, oh, he has metal in his head. So he had to go like this in a separate one because of his metal. And my grandma walked through it and went bang, 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 because she wears so much jewelry that I don't know how her blood circulation hasn't been cut off by now. And then, like, she's like, and like, oh, can you take off your jewelry? And he's like, no, I can't. And here's what made me a bit mad. So my mom and my brother both have, like, glasses. And I'm pretty sure it's metal, but it didn't beep. And so, you know, my bag goes through. I'm like, oh, it's going to be fine. But then they said, oh, we have to hold on to your bag. Something was tagged in it that, you know, we can't let it through. And we have to check it. And I'm like, all right, check it. I got nothing to hide. And but inside, I was dying. I have to take a medicine. I have to take quite a few medicines, okay? So I was worried that my mom had, like, this happened with my mom's bag, too. So with my backpack, I was like, all right, nothing's bad gonna happen to it. Except what happened was they told us to take our electronics out, and I did. Except I had a thing called Osmo. And I'm not sure if it qualified that, so I thought that was going to be the issue. But my mom had my medicine in her bag, so I was like, oh no, I'm going to die. Well, not die, but like, I'm going to lose all the products I need. So luckily, my mom's come through first, because it was the first to go through. And, wanna know what it was? Hand sanitizer. Because there's apparently a limit where you can only have 3 ounces of any liquid, really, unless you check it. And my mom wasn't that upset, you know, it's only $1. But, you know, mine goes through, and I have sunscreen in it from camp, and mom's like, oh, you better keep it in there. It was like, I don't know, 8 ounces or something. They take out, and they're like, okay, do you want us to check it or no? My mom said no. But now, she's literally kicking herself because it cost $10 to get it. So we had to once we got here, we had to pay it's late for me. We had to get more sunscreen, and yeah, that was fun. But then when we're there, my grandma's like, so did you tell them? And I'm just utterly confused. I'm like, oh no, did something bad happen? And then they're like, oh, well, actually, since we saved up, because we hadn't gone on a real vacation besides going to Mystic for a few days for 2 years, at least, okay? I want to say it's probably more than 3, but I know it's been a really long time since I flew something more with my mom. It's probably, I don't think we've gone since we went to Disney. So they've been saving up for 2 years. So we're flying first class, and I'm just like, oh my swirls. And so we get on, and then we're flying, you know, all goes well. But then they hear that I have Wi-Fi, and then I'm like, let's go! I get on the Wi-Fi. You can't even use it for anything besides, like, their streaming service that you need the app to use, okay? Except there was, like, this one thing, Ellen's Game of Games that I watched, but, like, that was all I could watch, really. Don't get me wrong, I liked it. It was only something that was age-appropriate for me. But here's the thing. Why get Wi-Fi if you can't even use it for anything? It's like, a duh-doy. Like, people aren't going to want